Hi, so welcome to another video which is related to NATA exam preparation, and today we are going to talk on the topic of color theory. So as you are aware that some color theory questions are generally asked in the MCQ format, say in the NATA exam. So what we have done is we have divided this video into three parts. The first part will be talking about the concept of colors and basics of color theory. So let's start. The first question is, what is color? And these are the options which you can see on the screen. The most appropriate answer out of this is light reflected from a surface. So these are the types of questions which will be coming in the MCQ format in the NATA exam. Next, what do we need to see colors? And our right answer is light. So without light, we cannot see colors. The next question, the color is affected by, and the right answer is nature of the light source. Next question, the name of a color family is called, and the right answer is hue. So the original colors are generally called as the hues of the colors. Next question, what colors cannot be made by mixing other colors? And the right answer is primary colors. So primary colors are the original colors which are mixed together to form secondary and intermediate colors. Next question, how do you get secondary colors? So the right answer is by mixing two primary colors. What is a color wheel? And the right answer for this question is the arrangement of colors in a spectrum. So as you can see, all colors, cool and warm, are displayed in a wheel format, and that's why it is called as a color wheel. Next, what is the value of a color, or value of a color is? And the right answer is lightness or darkness of a color. So remember this term value, because this question was asked in the previous year's exams. The next question, what are properties of a color, and you can describe a color by? And the right answer to this is option D, that is hue, intensity and value. So these are the three important properties of any color. Which of the following are cool colors? So there are two options which are correct in this question. One is option C and the second is option D. So this will come under the category of multiple select questions, or MSQ. Next question, the color's brightness or purity is called, and the right answer is intensity. When placed next to each other, these colors look their brightest, and the right answer for this is complementary colors. Next, the color scheme which is shown in the picture is which color scheme out of the four mentioned below? And the right answer is triadic color scheme split two. Now you can see why, because there are three colors, that's why it is a triadic color scheme. And they are split by a distance of two spaces each. So that's why it is triadic color scheme split two. Next, the color scheme in the picture shown below is. So you can see all colors which are next to each other, and that is called as an analogous color scheme. Then the next question is, which colors make green? And the simple answer to this is blue plus yellow. So green is a secondary color, and blue and yellow are primary colors. So when you mix two primary colors together, you get a secondary color. Next, which color makes orange? So again, the simple answer to this is yellow plus red. So again, you have to understand this fundamental that yellow and red is primary and orange is a secondary color. So you will have to mix two primary to get one secondary. Next, which color makes violet? So same logic, and the answer is red plus blue. Next question, a color scheme which is derived from a single base color is called, and the right answer to this is monochromatic color scheme. The contrasting colors for blue, yellow, red respectively are, and the right sequence would be orange, violet and green. So when you answer such questions, you have to be aware of which sequence you pick. Next, what is Pantone? So basically, Pantone is a system for matching colors. We will see another video in detail to learn about Pantone colors. Next question, what are additive colors? So additive colors are nothing but mixing of colored lights together. So let's read more about it. So cameras, televisions, phones and computer monitors use the additive color model. The additive color model describes how light produces color. The additive colors are red, green, blue or RGB. So whenever you have an RGB color scheme, it will be an additive color scheme. Now the additive color starts with black and adds red, green and blue light to produce the visible spectrum of colors. As more color is added, the result is lighter. Next question, which of these are subtractive colors? And the right answer to this is cyan, magenta, yellow and key. Key is the black color which you see in the middle. The subtractive color mixing is the kind of mixing you get if you illuminate colored filters with white light from behind. The commonly used subtractive primary colors are cyan, magenta and yellow. And if you overlap all three in effective equal measure, all the light is subtracted giving black. So that's the concept of subtractive colors. Now we are coming to the second part of this video, which is color as emotion. Now such questions are asked in the NATA exam, that they show you a painting or a picture and they ask you to identify what type of an emotion is being expressed in it or vice versa. So we can see the first question here. What class of colors are used to express the noise and activity of this dockyard scene? So basically this picture is trying to show you noise and activity, and the colors which are used here are nothing but opposite colors. So basically Antti Tervonen, the fave artist, uses the clash between opposite or complementary colors to express the noise and activity of this busy dockyard. Next question. What class of colors are used in this painting to express a sense of fun and excitement? And the right answer to this is primary colors. Jim Dine, the American pop artist, uses primary colors applied with the expressive brushstrokes to convey a sense of fun and excitement. Next question. Which emotion does this painting made by Pablo Picasso depict? And the right answer to this is sadness and despair. Then we come to the third part of this video, which is color symbolism. So we'll read the first question. Which art movement was interested in trying to capture the changing effects of color in nature? And the right answer to this is Impressionism. So Impressionism was the art movement where artists tried to capture the changing effects of light on the landscape by using a more exact analysis of tone and color. Then the next question, what is gray color used to symbolize? And the answer to this is decay. So let's see why. Gray is the natural color of some metals and stone, but it also has some negative associations with weather, boredom, decay and old age. Gray is a mixture of black, that is death, and white, that is peace, and is the color of ashes and dust. As such, it is also associated with death and mourning. Next question. What is orange color used to symbolize? And the right answer to this is creativity. So orange symbolizes creativity, change, energy and endurance. Next question. What is blue color used to symbolize? And the right answer to this is calm. So blue color indicates calmness. So blue is the coolest and most calming of all the colors. As the color of the sky, it has been used since ancient times to represent heaven. So I hope you like my video, and if you like it, so you can hit the like button and also share with your friends. Please don't forget to share the video with your friends and also subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are preparing for NATA exam. We are going to post many more such videos which will be very, very helpful for you for your preparation. Also follow us on our Instagram account, that is Architects Academy 5. Thanks a lot for watching.